that he is higher than the others. But kung dumaan ka as a local government employee worker, just like me, for 23 years, itong queuing, matagal ko na ito. In Davao, ang passport issuances na doon sa likod ng SM. Isang gabi, nagmotor ako, nakita ko yung mga paa sa simento. So I was thinking, anong nangyari dito? So nagbaba ako, sabi ko, bakit dito kayo natutulog? Sabi nila, you know, Mayor, ang pagbukas niyan, kailangan nakapila na kami. Pag hindi, sunod, ibang araw na naman kami. So, I called for the chief of office. When I said, look, I may not be the person above you supervising, but make sure that this thing will not happen tomorrow, as in tomorrow. Tapos tinawagan ko ang itong ano, sabi ko, why don't you give cards? Kung marami sila pag linya, may magkakad na marsyal, o ito, ikaw bukas, at 4 p.m. So you have to study the time and motion of people doing work. Sabi ko, ayaw ko dito sa Davao. Because Mindanao, nasa Davao ang ano eh, ang issuances ng passport. So ngayon, pagka-presidente ko, sabi ko, ayaw ko nang makita yan. Not during my time. Not during my time. Maghanap pa ng ibang panahon. Ayusin ninyo yan. I do not want people queuing under the heat of the sun and rain. Kaya, sabi ko, di magbigay kayo ng card. They should go to one window, magkuha kayo kung kailan sila makabalik. So divide, I should study your time and the motion of, you know, the process of. Andito nangyari na because I insisted. Today there is no more queuing, especially in the National Office, Statistics Office. Nakita ko. Talagang sabi ko na, either you fix the thing or I will resign tomorrow because I could not bear to see those people. Hindi sa panahon ko, hindi ko madala, hindi ko ang kayo mapatay, hindi ko kayo mabugbog. Ako ang alis sa gobyerno. Sabi ko, ayusin ninyo yan. Hindi ko gustong makita yan. Since 2016, the Office of the President has issued 138 executive orders, 43 administrative orders, 86 memorandum circulars, 52 memorandum orders, and 1,038 proclamations. These issuances have been integral guideposts government administration and development agenda. The Office of the President has demonstrated careful stewardship of the power by initiating reforms. We upgraded and improved the system and process sets to ensure that it can provide the best service to the institution of the presidency and the offices under it, ultimately to the Filipino people. To further promote transparency and accountability in government, we also issued the order of the freedom of information and opens the record of transaction decision issuances of all government agencies. In relation to this, we have also a presidential anti-corrupt commission that is tasked to run after corrupt and erring government officials and bring them to justice. Alam mo, I don't know if you perhaps have come to know about this. I have yung pastillas sa ano sa airport. There were 43 personnel involved. I fired them all. Talagang pinaalis ko sa gobyerno. Nagbalot mga ako ng pera sa pastillas. Sabi ko kay, magbalot ka, lagyan mo ng pera. Kaya ito ang ipakain ko sa kanila. Tinawag ko, 43 of them from the immigration. Mabuti na lang, nandiyan si Justice Secretary Guevara. So, that prevented me from doing it because kung hindi siya dumating, and I never expected him to be there, bigyan ko isa't isa yung papel at ipakain ko talaga yung pera sa kanila. Kung gusto mo ng pera, kainin mo. That is the best way of... Then you fire them. Customs 73 plus 42, and every day you have about... We have dismissed about 200 government personnel. But some I did not allow the publication because I may mga pamilya. So of late, yung sabi nila na huwag na lang ano kasi nasasaktan yung mga... So ngayon, wala na. I've stopped it. But there is no saying that we cannot reimpose it again for all of these idiots. I still have about a year to go. I will reach you somehow. But corruption is endemic in government. You cannot stop corruption. Nobody can stop corruption unless you overturn government completely. If I were the next president, if you think that there's really a need for you to change everybody in the system, then you declare martial law and fire everybody and allow the new generation to come in to work for government. E kung hindi mo ganunin, walang mangyari. Nandiyan it's in the system. Kagaya ng drugs. Sino ba na mamniwala na nine generals sa police were into trafficking of drugs? And because they are policemen, the charges simply disappeared. Because the prosecution, the investigation, which form part of the vital documents in court, wala, nobody was investigating. Because they are also policemen. Kaya yan kahirap mga ano. Kaya gusto mo, itong mga to, talagang the only way to do it, just call them and say, look for another job. Don't. Ganun kahirap. Now, let me pursue my talk with the foreign policy of the country. In the international arena, we have vigorously pursued an independent